Okay, we're back. And shit, Sabrina, what is up, guys? Welcome back to a new video. My name is Tristan. If you don't know, I do some reaction videos occasionally. People were like, "Oh, Tristan, are you gonna do the short and sweet reaction?" And low-key, I've been like, "No." I'm in the midst of moving right now, and it's been a process. I am not in my normal room because I no longer live in my normal room. Shout out Delon and the House of Lords who are out here housing me right now as I go through a transition of moving out of LA. Now that is a different story for another time, but I'm gonna do it anyways. I'm gonna make a Sabrina Carpenter short and sweet video because the fans have asked for it, and I shall deliver. Sabrina Carpenter has been blowing up nonstop since the whole driver's license era, and I know she's been working on her craft since way before. Sabrina Carpenter's last album, Emails I Can't Send, has become a hit sensation, and I have fallen in love with it. It wasn't until very late in the game that I started to realize that she has so many hidden bops and her music is just, it's got taste. Ooh. Today we're gonna look into Sabrina Carpenter's new album, Short and Sweet, and I'm going to try and give a little bit more of a analytical, critical view on it. I know I usually get really excited, and I know that I will eventually get really excited anyways. So you don't have to worry about me not getting excited when I see Sabrina Carpenter out of all people, but I'm gonna try and dissect the lyrics and read into it, see if there's like anything. So I also have the lyric videos queued up with me right here so that I could read off of them. We can pause, we can take a look at what she could be possibly alluding to, talking about. I've listened to a couple of her interviews leading up to this album, and also I just saw her live 2 weeks ago in San Francisco at Outside Lands, and that was freaking amazing. I screamed the loudest that I ever have for her out of any other performer in Outside Lands, and she deserved it. And Sabrina, I hope you know, when you started playing Espresso, which was the last song that you played, my nose started immediately bleeding. Like immediately when, you hear Dutch, dun, now me's. And then all of a sudden, as she's saying, "Think about me," my nose started going all blood in the middle of the festival. And I start shaking putting my booty out and like giving space. And I was like, "Think about me, about me, about singing that best song." And then when she would stop singing, right, the part where there's like a little bit of break, I'd be like, "Anyone have a tissue? Anyone have a tissue?" And then someone in front of me was like, "Yeah, I got you, I got you." So I luckily got a tissue, but oh my God, that was insane. And that was all you, Sabrina. Like, only you can make my nose bleed like that. So, yeah. That is my experience with the Sabrina Carpenter effect. Short and Sweet is Sabrina Carpenter's sixth album, and I am assuming, based on what I have read and heard and listened to and watched, that it is a lot more of a mature version of who she has become, while also showing that maturity and growing up doesn't necessarily mean you have to get so poetically deep into things. I'm expecting a lot of humor in a lot of her lyricism. Seems like she wrote a lot of this in France. We're gonna start this out right now, right here, starting off with number one, Taste, which I've heard a lot about, and not only are we going to be reacting to the song, but there's a music video to come along with it. And the thumbnail has Mrs. Jenna Ortega in it. So, what could this possibly mean? I have no clue. We'll see. This is short and sweet. Parental advisory and viewer warning. Okay. Interesting. Graphic violence. Expected nothing less. Okay, Prada. First of all, that font is taste. Okay. There are people out here picking out these fonts and creating them. Gotta give a shout out. Okay, Dave Myers, let's see what you got. Oh, I leave quite an impression. 5 feet to be exact. You're wondering why I have his clothes when missing my body's where they're at. Oh. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. She just died. That is so... She's like stuck inside of the fence. I love it. It seems like a friends to lovers to enemies. No, it seems like a frenemy situation they got going on. Jenna Ortega is sleeping with this man who Sabrina is like, girl, why are you sleeping with my mans, you know? She about to kill him. Why am I explaining this? I'm overanalyzing it. I'm getting too excited. I need to calm down, get into my analytical brain. I don't know, maybe this is just a hunch, but there's been things circulating in the past about this sort of love triangle going on. And I'm not talking about this Joshua Bassett, Sabrina Carpenter, Olivia Rodrigo thing. That is of the past now. I'm talking about my man and my woman, Shawn Mendes and Camila Cabello, and Sabrina Carpenter being in the middle of it, and I don't know what's going on, but they were together. Shawn and Sabrina were together for a little bit, and then all of a sudden, Shawn went off to LA to Coachella and was with Camila, and then Camila made her album, and then Shawn's making his album, and now Sabrina has her album. So coincidence, I think not. Oh, that looks so good. Those heels, oh my god. Of course. Okay, Kill Bill reference. The back of this guy's head looks a lot like Shawn Mendes. I don't know. Maybe I'm just overthinking it. Maybe. But also, is that fire real? That's the real question. Oh. Oh, she voodoo dolled her. Oh, she just died. Oh. She's on fire. Down. Psycho. Whoa. They're kissing. The girls are kissing. Guys, it was an enemies to lovers trope. I was right and then I was wrong. Also, the lyric, okay? I heard you're back together. Guys, this is about Shawn Mendes and Camila Cabello. And that makes sense because Jenna Ortega kind of looks like Camila Cabello, like pre, like, CXOXO era, which is very, very interesting. And now she's pulling a Challengers right now, but gender swapped Challengers. So, I'm here for it. I'm all here for it. Hot people are doing hot things. Oh. Why would you do that, Jenna? Oh, wait. Oh. Beloved boyfriend. That looks like Shawn Mendes. They kind of went for him, but I loved it. She's got humor. I will give her that. And that song was boppy as fuck. So I'm gonna give her that. The way they reference so many movies that I can't even name off the top of my head, except for Tarantino. Love it. It's got vibes. It's got vibes. This next one is called Please, Please, Please. But we've already done a music video reaction to it. So we're just gonna jam. As we go to Tristan from the past doing the Please, Please, Please music video reaction. Also, all of these like really remind me of like Telephone featuring Beyonce, Lady Gaga, Beyonce Telephone with the jail, with the Tarantino, you know, and the two girls like doing their thing, like killing people. I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. Wrong artist. Wrong artist.
I am at work right now, but I am on a lunch break, so don't come for me. I got some free jerky that I got because I work at the Rescuing Leftovers Cuisine, and I was doing some food donations, and then the World Harvest Market was like, hey, get some free jerky. So they gave me some free jerky. They did not give me an option to say no. I tried saying no, and they're like, no, you're gonna love this. So this is my lunch break. I'm gonna eat. This is the everything grass-fed beef jerky made with everything bagel seasoning. Interesting. It's also a food tasting video, I guess. It tastes like beef jerky with everything bagel seasoning. Interesting combination, peak creativity. I don't know how it's gonna get better than this when I watch this music video, but we'll see. Okay, jail. It's giving Telephone, Lady Gaga. Hello, hello, baby, call, I can hear a thing. Sorry, I'm not growing, same, it's all the same, same.
Do you guys hear Espresso in the background? I actually love her. Of course. It's Mr. Barry himself. Of course he had to make a cameo. What's next? Are they gonna kiss? Okay. This is kinda cute. Okay, what if this is like the universe where it's like post-Saltburn, you know? Because it's like, it takes place in that aspect. He got arrested, you know? Different timeline. I don't know. Whatever.
It's oh. Just your culture.
Oh.
And everyone rolls their eyes.
Okay, he a mobster.
All I'm asking, baby. Please, 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 don't prove I'm right.
Ooh, I'm loving this video. You know, Sabrina has fallen in love with a prison ex-convict / current convict. And now she's visiting his family, I guess, and watching him get beat up. I like how this is like the follow-up to that amazing song that we all know as the pop summer song of the century, Espresso. It's like a lot more mellow, you know, because I think we've gotten Feather, we've gotten Nonsense, not in that order, and then we got Espresso. So it just like kept building up to this like big pop, 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 like jamming. And now this is a little bit more mellow, which I think is exactly what we kind of needed. So please, please, please.
Please, please, please don't bring me to tears when I just did my makeup so nice.
Oh.
Heartbreak is one thing, my ego's another. I
beg you,
don't embarrass me, motherfucker.
Okay, the way that she said, motherfucker. Very country. I like it. I like how the world has been shifting to making country a lot more popular, because it has been popular, but it's like country is like now sort of mainstream, you know. Thank you, Beyonce. Thank you, Morgan Wallen. Thank you, Taylor Swift, and everyone who has continued to kind of shift the dynamic of where we see country. Love this plot. They're just hiding a body together. Very partners in crime vibes.
I have a fun idea, babe. Maybe just stay inside.
Oh.
I know you're craving some fresh air, but the ceiling fan is so nice, and we could live so happily.
I love that they're kind of playing with us. They know they're like hot shit, and they're kind of flirting while like doing something batshit crazy and very illegal. So
please, please, please don't bring me to tears when I just did my makeup so nice.
Okay, so I'm assuming that she sold him out, or you know, they kind of just put him, pinned it on him, and that's cute. Okay, can I just say, I love these fur jackets that she's got going on. The different colors from pink to lime green. She just is stunning with the outfits. And then Barry Keoghan is just, he just is wearing the same black polo, but it's pretty nice. It fits him really well. You gonna do it? No. Whoa, go back. Did you see the light, the headlights go down? Whoa. Okay, I didn't know that cars did that. That's pretty crazy. that lip bite though. Okay, sorry, I can't do it like him. It's about to get kinky. The lipstick.
Oh, cute. Love it.
I'm gonna say something very controversial. I appreciate espresso, because it is definitely the pop summer song, but I don't really enjoy it that much. This song, I vibe with. Maybe it's just because I like mellow music, maybe because I'm a bit of a sad guy. Enjoyed it a lot. Let's look into the lyrics. So what I'm getting from this song, and I think it's really cool that Barry Keoghan's in it, because I think the song very much relates to the idea of like the public persona and like what this relationship is. She's kind of begging like for this relationship to be protected in some ways, to make sure that even though she knows that they're all like popular and everyone's eyes are on them, she's like, don't fuck this up, because it could very easily be fucked up because they are in the eyes of the public. We all know how relationships in the public persona can go. They either stay together or they break up. But every single problem, you know, is very much highlighted, and it's not easy. So we'll see how they go. Big fan of them. I ship them. I think they're really cute. What is the chorus? Please, please, please don't prove them right. I think that's like a very clear reference to her saying, like, don't make everyone, like, they're painting us out as like this bad couple, you know, and they just want to have the idea and feed into the drama, you know. Well, I have a fun idea, babe. Uh-huh. Maybe just stay inside. I know you're craving some fresh air, but the ceiling fan is so nice. It's so much easier to just hide. And I think she perfectly encapsulates like what is kind of going on. As much as a pop star that she can be, like, her lyrics have some depth and they seem to be a little bit personal to what's going on in her mind. So I really appreciate it. I'm excited to see what she has in store.
Okay, so this next song is called Good Graces, which I don't know what that means, but good graces. It's about to be a bop. It's a great follow-up to Please, 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 because I think it kind of is saying the same message, which is, boy, if you go and date me, like, literally just don't be fucking stupid. Be literally do the bare minimum and be a good person. Don't fuck it up. That was cool. I agree. Us. All right, here comes the bridge. Here we go. Now, don't get me wrong, I like that song. It's catchy as fuck. Because it kind of says the same thing over and over again. And that's what I love about pop music. I thought she was gonna go a little bit more ham outside of I Won't Give a Fuck About You. But it's simple and it's short and it's sweet. So I'll give you that, Sabrina. The next song is called Sharpest Tool. I think I'm gonna like this one. I know. You're not the sharpest tool in the shed. We had said, then a bird flies by and you forget. I don't hear a word till your guilt creeps in. Tuesday, send us
think we're fine. You're confused and I'm upset, but we never talk about it.
She's going off here. She's starting off by saying, you're a little silly, you know. We had sex, I met your friends. So like, we're like leading into relationship territory, right? However, then all of a sudden, you pull this 180 and you're like, you're dumb. And you think we're fine? No, we're not. But we don't talk about it. Cause why? She's either alluding to we don't talk anymore or we pretend that we're fine. You know, I have sympathy for both sides. It can be awkward when you pull a 180 and it's like really awkward to admit that your feelings have changed. And also, you know, I've been on the other side where someone's pulled a 180 on me. And you know, I have compassion for everyone. Compassion wins. I'm not trying to get into the... Okay, I am. But Sabrina is known to have dated two people who have found God. Those two people being Joshua Bassett and Shawn Mendes at their ex's house. Now, I don't know what's going on there, but that is very interesting. Very, very interesting. Left her dumbfounded. It seems like Sabrina is saying, I'm smarter than you think that I am. I am in the know of what is going on, and we don't talk about it because you think that I don't know, but I know that you know, but you don't know that I know what you know. I think it's the idea that no contact kind of fucks you up, and it's also the attachment theory, you know, when you're attached to someone, right, and someone suddenly pulls away, the other person wants nothing more than to just whoosh, and that causes the other magnet to pull away even further, and it just causes this sort of thing. Until Mr. Anxious over here, Mr. and Mrs., they, them, detaches, and then all of a sudden, Mr. Avoidant, Mr. and Mrs., they, them, are like, wait, where did you go? I miss you now. And then it's a push-pull, and then it just happens over and over again. Sorry, done a little way too much research on the attachment theory, but it's for my own benefit. Love me some self-help. Popping off. I love how Sabrina can be so mellow about things, but also kind of be like, whoosh, 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 whoosh. I don't know if that made any sense, but it seems like your girl has been done dirty. She's been traumatized. Do not send hate out there. Because everyone else out there in the world has trauma and poison of their own. And you just gotta like have compassion for all sides. There's a reason why people did the things that they did, and it sucks. But you can't blame people for doing what they gotta do to find happiness, even if it's doing you dirty. Because it's not personal. It seems like this person who... Okay, I'm literally defending the men who have, like, done her dirty. Why am I doing this? See? I need to stop giving people the benefit of the doubt. However, compassion. Okay, this next song is called Coincidence, which I have said multiple times already today, which is such a coincidence because now her song is called Coincidence, which that's got to be a coincidence. I think not. This sounds like a Lumineer song.
She's got
She's talking about an ex. For real, girl. You talking about Camila Cabello. See, XOXO, the girls are wet. You know it. Coachella? Seems like Sabrina is very much calling out the fact that she's being used. She's going off. -7%. Why 7? Guys, Palm Springs is like Coachella adjacent. Cindy Lou Who. Oh my god. Damn, she looks like the girl that you thought you outgrew. Oh! They did. Oh my god. What a last liner. May I just say something? I think Sabrina is the girly who seems to always have the last say on everything. I mean, you know, when you think about the Joshua Bassett, Olivia Rodrigo, Sabrina Carpenter love triangle. Okay, never mind. Joshua had the last say. But then Sabrina came back with her deluxe. And then she did have the last say. So, you know what? I am right. She does have the last say. Bad Chem. Bed Chem is next. Prediction. She's going to take a little bit of a break from this little situationship. And hop into the alchemy, as Taylor Swift would, you know, and talk about her current boyfriend, which is Mr. Barry Keoghan, because they got bed chem. I was in a sheer dress the day that we met. We were both in a rush. We talked for a second. You friended me up so we could connect. And what are the odds? You sent me a text and I'm the next. Thing I know I'm like, manifest, not your oversized. Thick accent. She said, come right on me. I mean, come right on, camaraderie. I can't even say camaraderie. Love that. She got humor. I love her, your way of words. Also, it's a very interesting story because I've always been very curious as to how, you know, they got together. I think it was through a tweet or something. And then I guess like a friend connected her. And that's LA, baby, the networking industry. It's all about the connections. And then the bed chem just happens. What you wanna be? Where art thou? Why not a part of me? See it in my mind, let's fulfill the prophecy. It's the cute guy with the white blue eyes and the big bad. Big bad. Like. Because they both come at the same time. Six. That's a sexual position, guys. What did she say at the end? Not my favorite, not gonna lie. Not my favorite song. However, it kind of bops, and I like the story. Oh. Okay. I think I know this song. Oh my god, what's going on? Those, prepare yourself. I need some water. Or do I need some espresso? I'm a singer, I got so cute, wrapped in my finger, it's a humor. Espresso feels like a good follow-up to bed chem, you know? It's just that, like, now we got bed chem, I met this guy, we're doing great, and now I'm having fun, and I'm living the time of my life, espresso. I like to think about the ordering of albums and their song choices. Anyways, okay, this is Dumb and Depeche Poetic. It's just what I fall for, like the aesthetic. I feel called out a little bit by that first line. Not that I'm dumb and poetic, but I think I like dumb and poetic people. A little bit of a aloofness, but also some artsiness. That's my type, guys. So if you are one of those dumb and poetics out there, I think you and I would have some good bed chem. Okay, moving on. Oh! So I'm not gonna speak anymore, and I'm just gonna just, I think I am a dumb and poetic guy. Sabrina, if you and Barry don't work out or you need a third, let me know. I am here. I got more self-help books packed up right now, and a lot more self-help knowledge up in here, and my obsession does not stop. You are actually, this camera right now is stacked on a bunch of self-help books right now. That is how I did my makeshift tripod out here. So, Sabrina, just, you know, hit me up. I love self-help books. This seems like it's about Joshua Bassett, because Olivia made a song where she's like, I read every single one of your self-help books to make you think that I'm smarter. Joshua seems like a self-help book type, which means that Joshua seems like a Tristan type. Oh my god, Joshua, hit me up. You and I would be homies. I apologize for making this video. Art is art, you know, and I'm happy for you. You found God, you found Jesus, and I would like to find Jesus too. Compassion. Compassion. You've already been cherry pick lines like they're words you invented. Cool stuff for highbrow manipulation and love everyone is your favorite quotation. Okay. I feel extremely called out right now because love everyone. Come on, guys. That's pretty much the same thing as saying compassion for all. Fuck. Sabrina actually would hate me. That's not true, because I would give her good graces. I'm not the sharpest tool, but Sabrina, I would give you some good graces, and you know it. I was screaming for you at your concert, and I don't think anyone screamed as loud as I did. Just saying, because I bled for you. I literally bled for you, so, you know. Sabrina, Barry, hit me up anytime. I'm right here. Comment sections is completely open for you. Try to come up like you're soft and unspoken. Jack off to lyrics by Leonard Cohen. Don't think you Okay, we're back. And shit, Sabrina, let's just continue.
You're so sad, there's no communication, but baby, you put us in this situation.
Sabrina.
You're running so fast from the hearts that you're breaking. Save all your breath for your floor meditation. You're so empathetic, you would make a great wife, and I
I would.
promise
She's actually calling me out. I know she's calling out Joshua Bassett right now, but she's calling me out, which makes me feel like I've known this for a really long time. I think Joshua and I would be great friends because we're pretty much the same freaking person, minus the musical talent. But my talent comes more in filmmaking, so I make up for that, you know. I think. We'll see. Joshua, I'm coming for you. In like the most sweetest way possible. I'm not like coming for you, like, watch out, you know. Maybe watch out because we're about to be besties, you and I.
Just 'cause you act like one doesn't make
It makes me a better man. Check out Better Man streaming live on YouTube on this channel right now, guys. Sabrina Carpenter has endorsed it because she's literally calling out this film. This song is about this film, directed by me and the person who actually owns this room. Shout out Delon, shout out Joshua, shout out Sabrina, shout out Compassion, shout out Shawn Mendes, and shout out Camila Cabello because the girls are wet. This next song is called Slim Pickens, which I've heard already live when she played it for us at Outside Lands, and I was screaming, guys, but I didn't actually hear the lyrics. So, oh, don't do that, Sabrina. I get it. I have compassion. Yeah. Delete them. Yeah. I agree. A
boy who's jacked and kind can't find his has to save my life. Oh, it's Slim Pickens.
Personally, I do not understand what Slim Pickens means. It's got this like Dolly Parton type beat, and I love it. And I love it. I love it. I love it. Wrong artist. Wrong artist.
If I can't have the one I love, I guess it's you that I'll be kissing just to get my fixings.
No.
Since the good ones are deceased or taken, I'll just keep on moaning and bitching.
What is she doing?
Jesus, what's a girl to do? This boy doesn't even know the difference between there and they are. Yet he's naked in my room.
These dumb
missing all
boys.
the things he's missing. God knows that he isn't living large. A boy who's nice that breathes. I swear he's nowhere to be seen. It's Slim Pickens. Since the good ones call her.
Ooh.
Since the Lord forgot my gay awakening,
what?
And I'll just be here in the kitchen serving up some morning
Her gay awakening. That's her kissing Jenna Ortega right there. Slim Pickens seems like it's about this like sort of hookup culture, you know? And she's just hooking up with people to get her fix, her sexual needs. There's an underlying tone of someone's like horniness and sexual desires, which is an emotional desire, I believe. And she's looking for someone who's compatible for her. and she can't find it. But it seems like sex, you know, with multiple fixins, some slim pickins, is her way to go. And trust me, I've been there. It's tough, you know, because you're like, I feel like I need to find the one. And then you're like, wait, like, there's literally no one, because I can't find anyone. They're like not out there. So I'm just gonna settle for this fella over here. And you're like, this fella is not for me, but they'll do, I guess. And that's sad. No, choose yourself. It's so much harder to do. So much easier said than done. And I feel like once you choose yourself, the person that you are manifesting will show up. Anyways, this is Juno by Claro. Were we on this chair already? What is Juno? High five. You're silly, Sabrina. What does that mean? One of me but two? I guess it's two people. I don't know. Hold me and explore me. Mark your territory. Oh. Tell me I'm the only one. Me. Hold me and explore me. I'm so fucking hard. Yeah, you are. I like that song. That was cute. That was a bop. I loved it. It was happy. And it feels like another great follow-up to the previous song, which is about like not really finding the one. And then you do find the one, you know, settling down for just someone. And then finding someone you don't even have to settle for. Or like you're like, ugh, whatever. You're like, I actually want this. It's a mutual thing. Love it. This is Lida Girls. Swear on your mom that it's the first drink that you've had in like a month. Never seen an ugly truth that I can't bend to something that looks better. I'm stupid but I'm clever. Yeah, I can make a shit show look a whole lot like forever and ever. I think I said this already before, and now she's kind of being like just saying it directly. Sabrina knows. She is in the know. She's not as dumb as you think. But you guys probably don't think that she's dumb at all. And I don't either. But she knows a lot more than meets the eye. And she's saying that in Lie to Girls. Don't lie to girls. Don't lie. Ooh. Oh, what's going on?
All your best excuses really don't stand a chance against all the chances I give you.
It's got a little bit of trap beat. Hey. Okay, can you turn that bass up though? It's like soft, but it's like it's going hard, you know. Ooh. I like the sound design here. It's like there's a lot of elements behind the scenes, you know. Build up. This honestly, it feels like a kind of like a Taylor Swift song. I don't know. Whew. Feels like a good closer. Things are ending, you know? Loved it. Cool, we're gonna take a little bit of a break because I have a meeting to hop onto, so I will see you in about an hour. Okay, we're back for our last song reaction. Took a little bit of detour, but we're here. This is Don't Smile by Sabrina Carpenter. I heard through the Zane Lowe podcast that this song is actually not autobiographical and it's about her friend going through a breakup. I'm curious as if it's a famous friend, if it's someone we know mutually. If not, that's okay. I know that it's about like all those like Pinterest boards are like, don't be sad that it's over, smile because it happened, and it's like kind of the opposite of that. Very interested to see what that is. I also feel that Lie to Girls feels like an outro, so I'm interested is if this is like a PS I'm still here kind of thing that Gracie Abrams did in her last album for The Story of Us, because she also said in her podcast interview that the song Close to You is kind of like a second outro, where Free Now is like the actual outro. Those are my thoughts. Don't Smile, here we go. Okay, I like the visual of the heart, just like, it's got an R&B like vibe to it. Okay. I love Sabrina for being as petty as she is. She deserves to be like this, and I think that's catchy to kind of take that sort of cliche and flip the entire script on it. My heart is heavy now, it's like 100 pounds, it's falling faster than the way you love to show me down. I think I need a shower, my friends are taking shots, you think it's happy hour. The song has kind of like a psychedelic vibe, and in that sense it's also kind of interesting because she's also sort of manifesting with the I want you to miss me, telling this person how to feel, this ex, I guess, ex situationship person, this is how you should be feeling, and like she's kind of manifesting, channeling that want into the other person. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Wrong artist. Wrong artist. Pour my feelings in the microphone. I stay in them when the girls come home. I want one of them to take my phone. Take my phone and lose your. No This would be such a good Ariana Grande song. Just say, I love it. I love you, Sabrina. But think about it. If Ariana sang this, it would be over. It would be over. Because it's also the witch vibes, you know? Oh, and in the lyric video, she's like, you know, dangling that little, just kind of hypnotizing you. Ah. Bestie, where is the deluxe album? Where's the deluxe album? That's all I'm saying. Where is the deluxe album? I love this song. It's very interesting. I've definitely been there, you know, where I don't want this person's number. I don't want to be tempted. It just sucks. And I can tell that Sabrina, she be hurting, or not her friend, I guess. Short and sweet. I love kind of the message she's trying to share with her album in full, in succession. As she says in her interview, it's not called short and sweet because she's just vertically challenged. She is also calling this album short and sweet because a lot of the relationships that she's been in were very short. However, they were the ones that affected her the most. And that's why, hence the name Short and Sweet. And it's beautiful because, I'm so sorry, Taylor, but it feels like a much shorter Tortured Poets Department, which a lot of people will like bash on Taylor for, because everyone I know is saying that Tortured Poets Department did not have to be that long. Like, don't you know how to cut songs out? However, I appreciate Tortured Poets Department for being two albums long. Short and Sweet, though, feels like it tackles very similar themes of being in a situationship and then finding someone that you're meant for. With Taylor Swift, you know, there's the Matty Healy, Joe Alwyn, Travis Kelce sort of storyline. With Sabrina Carpenter, it seems like there's this Joshua Bassett, Shawn Mendes, Camila Cabello, and Barry Keoghan storyline going on. Everyone's got their own narrative, their own plot lines, and she kind of condensed it all into a much shorter album than Taylor did. I did not mean to compare them. That kind of just naturally came out of me. However, they are friends, and also Jack Antonoff produced both of them. Shout out, Jack. Love you. Compassion. Also, self-help. Stream all of my self-help books that I'm not producing. But check this one out. It's called The Four Agreements. It's a really great book, and it talks about the four agreements that we should all live by in the Toltec. It's very much helped me like reshape my life. Obviously, I'm still growing, I'm still human, I'm still making mistakes, but it's making me more aware of how I want to move forward in my life and what sort of things I want to share around the world. I know this is all boring stuff, you guys don't care, but compassion is very important. I love self-help. Okay, this did not have to, I literally am the epitome of what Sabrina Carpenter like hates in men. So I'm just gonna stop. I know Sabrina, I know you don't like me, but I think you also would like me. You would be probably pretty infatuated by my taste in self-help. My favorite songs, definitely Please, Please, Please is still up there. Gotta give Taste another listen though, because I really liked it. Slim Pickens, now that song I will be restreaming. Juno is definitely the most like fun, loving, you know. Espresso though, bop to the bop. Song of the summer, for real. And then Dumb and Poetic is the one that called me out the most. Coincidence, I really liked it. It just feels like this whole rush of just, your head is just going spinning and going crazy. And I love the humor that you have, Sabrina. You're a great writer, and I love you for that. So Sabrina, thank you so much for blessing us with Short and Sweet. Go stream it. And thank you guys for watching this video if you got this far. If you did, please comment your favorite song on the album, what you think that, I don't know, your interpretations of everything, your thoughts, your feelings. I'd love to hear it. I'd love to engage with you guys. If this is your first reaction video of mine that you're watching, I appreciate it. If it's not your first. I would love to know what you think, how it's done, if I've improved as a album reactioner. I know I got a little excited and I got less analytical there. It's good that I had that intention in mind because I think I held myself to a more, I don't know what I'm saying. Goodbye, guys. Goodbye, LA, also, because damn, I'll be leaving. But that's a story for another time. Peace.